Let's see the difference between using this 6-inch GoTo Virtuoso telescope with a camera and also the tiny smart telescope, the DWARF II. We will be capturing Whirlpool Galaxy M51 using the DWARF as is without any filter, anything else, just connected to the smartphone. But the 6-inch Virtuoso GoTo Skywatcher needs a camera attached to it.
Messier 51, the Whirlpool Galaxy, it's a very popular and majestic spiral galaxy located in Canis Venatici constellation. You just have to find a Big Dipper in the sky and point your telescope more or less to this position with the help of a telrad or a finder. You can also watch it visually, but for that though, you will need good seeing and darkness. The arms of this galaxy are huge star formation areas. In this Hubble Team image, we can not only see that with high quality, but also its small companion, NGC 5195, interacting and boosting the star formation.
So I will be using my 294 from ZWO, which is a great camera with a large field of view that match very well with this Dobsonian telescope. And there's a strong reason for me to choose this comparison specifically with a DWARF smart telescope and a 6-inch Virtuoso by the other hand. And that reason is another advantage of having small telescopes, but now in this video we will find out which one is better, the DWARF or the 6-inch Virtuoso.
You know those nights that you are super tired because you had a complicated day full of things to do? And you just want to go home, have your dinner and sit on the sofa, relax, to rest your body and soul. But then after a while you go outside, you look at the sky and the sky is gorgeous. And after you get night after night of clouds, preventing you to watch the sky with your telescope, you almost feel guilty if you don't grab your telescope that night to place it outside and enjoy the sky. Well, the solution for me was to place the Virtuoso 6-inch telescope, which is a light telescope and easy to grab and place. I just had to connect it to my laptop and using the camera, I decided to watch the beautiful Whirlpool Galaxy. So I used SharpCap software and started live stacking the image. That means using short exposures, the software takes picture after picture, stacking them to get a brighter, sharper and much more beautiful picture. And while I was doing that, I was seated comfortably inside the house at my desk. That's because the Virtuoso telescope has a GoTo, so that allows me, with the application SceneScan, to control all the movements of this telescope while it is tracking the sky. So the deep sky object that I'm watching can be always in the field of view. Yes, I was tired but happy, so I asked myself why not to place the tiny telescope, the DWARF II, also outside. So then I can compare the pictures. And I did that. I connected it just with a push of a button and then I used my smartphone to connect with the DWARF II with the Wi-Fi. Remember, the DWARF II has its own Wi-Fi and the same happened with the Virtuoso 6-inch telescope. So that means that we can be anywhere in the world and connect any of these telescopes to a smartphone. This is because we don't need any internet connection. Well, you need batteries, of course, but for that I recommend you a power supply like the one I have, an UPS, which is better than a power bank and lasts for several nights in a row, allowing you to use these telescopes in an environment without any electricity for a while. That means if you go to a dark site doing camping, of course, because if you are in a house you have power supply. Then after calibrating the DWARF, focusing it and select the M51 target on the GoTo catalog, I chose 99 frames with 15 seconds each, which means around 25 minutes. The image straight away was beautiful after the auto stretch of the DWARF II being applied. But there was only after some minutes when the dwarf showed up at all its glory. But we need to check how the 6-inch Virtuoso was doing the same life stacking. The best place to buy the Dwarf 2 right now is at Dwarf Lab, and the 6-inch Virtuoso telescope, which sells a lot, it's on AstroArt Finland, your astronomical partner. And it's also our sponsor, so always check the prices there before you buy, because they have excellent prices if you live on Europe or United Kingdom. But meanwhile, I was having trouble with the 6-inch Virtuoso. For some reason, the object moved from the field of view and the software stopped stacking. Therefore, I had to pause it, recenter the object and resume. And fortunately, it worked. It kept stacking, and with just around 20 minutes, the image of this galaxy in real time was much better. But after the stacking, I picked both images, the one from the dwarf and the other from the Virtuoso, and doing just a quick astrophotography with topaz denoise, this was the result. So you can clearly see that the image from the 6-inch Virtuoso is much better. And the reason for that is because the Virtuoso has a larger aperture, it's a Dobsonian telescope and has a great camera attached to it. You have the links to buy both telescopes and all of my gear down below in the description. So both telescopes have more or less the same price, which is a great price for the moment. I'm sure it will go up. However, to do astrophotography or live stacking with the 6-inch Virtuoso, you gotta have a camera. In addition to that, the 6-inch Virtuoso has a great advantage, which is the visual component. You can watch visually through an eyepiece, and it comes with two eyepieces and a collimator, the brightest objects in the sky, loads of them. By the other hand, the dwarf is so tiny and portable that you can almost put it in a pocket and go. And it's very convenient to do outreach or for educational purposes, like showing to the children and people that are not in astronomy the beauty of the night sky in real time. The 6-inch Virtuoso is still my best recommendation for a beginner. You can do it all, and it's a professional telescope with a large aperture. But if you just want something ready to go to do camping or traveling or something like that, the Dwarf is the solution. You just connect it and go. Amazing! Now click on this video over here where I show you a great adventure I had with these two telescopes. However, this time the winner was the smart telescope Dwarf 2.